CompTIA ITF Plus Complete Training Course. Exam Objective 2.7, Explain Basic Networking Concepts. HTTP and HTTPS. Up to now, we have discussed networking protocols that support the addressing and forwarding of data packets to their intended destinations. With that behind us, we will move forward with application protocols. Application protocols deal with the data or payloads themselves. And I am going to start with a protocol most of us are already familiar with. HTTP. HTTP stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol and is the foundation of data communication on the World Wide Web. HTTP enables web browsers and servers to exchange information, allowing you to access and view web pages and other resources on the internet. In simpler terms, think of it as a set of rules that allow web browsers and web servers to understand and exchange information with each other. For a moment, imagine you're using a web browser, like Chrome or Firefox, to access a website. When you type the website's address into the URL bar and hit enter, your browser sends an HTTP request to the web server hosting that site, asking for the web page's content. The server then processes the request and sends back an HTTP response containing the requested web page's data. This entire process happens seamlessly in the background, enabling you to see the web page on your screen. This all happens because of the HTTP protocol. Now you should know that HTTP is not a secure protocol. And if you need to access your bank account information or any other sensitive information, you will not want to use HTTP. So what should you use? The answer is HTTPS. HTTPS stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol Secure, and is a secure version of the standard HTTP protocol used for data communication on the World Wide Web. HTTPS incorporates an additional layer of security using encryption to protect the data being transmitted between a user's web browser and a web server. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for more great content.